What's up, everyone? So today is the World Day Against Cyber Censorship, which is observed annually on March 12th. I'm sure everyone knew this. I didn't actually know it till today, and it's March 12th. So, but it was established by Reporters Without Borders, or RSF, and Amnesty International way back in 2008. And it promotes internet freedom, calls for an end to government-imposed online restrictions, and celebrates those who oppose such censorship. This day is supposed to hit home the importance of free expression on the internet and honor the efforts to combat the global trend of increasing government censorship. So, in celebration of this day, the Tor Project announced an essential development in digital privacy and freedom. They've released WebTunnel, which is a new bridge for the Tor network, which is massive. We now have it available inside the Tor browser's stable version. This innovation is especially significant for users in regions where censorship heavily restricts internet access. Well, that's great, but what's a bridge anyways? Well, real quickly, the Tor network is a powerful tool for anonymous web browsing. It enables users to keep their internet activities private and bypass censorship. It's an overlay network. Much like chocolate coating on ice cream, it's built on top of the existing structure of the internet. This design helps mask your online footprint, making your actions less traceable back to you. There's a massive difference between privacy and anonymity, and Tor gives you the latter with relative ease in comparison to some other methodologies. In regions where censorship is aggressively enforced, like Russia's long-standing efforts to suppress Tor usage.
Okay, hi, I'm Roger, and I'm going to talk today about Russia and censorship and Tor. I've got way too much to say and a lot of different topics, so I'll try to give everybody something interesting and fun that they haven't thought about before.
Accessing the network can pose significant challenges, and in some countries, have lethal consequences. So that's precisely the role that bridges play in the Tor ecosystem. These bridges are essentially undisclosed entry points to the Tor network, like secret doorways that are designed to be difficult for censors like Agent Smith. It's a joke.
As you can see, we've had our eye on you for some time now, Mr. Anderson.
Or, you know, even your own ISP to detect and block. While their primary purpose is to circumvent censorship, they also serve an important secondary function, which is shielding your internet activities from your ISP if your ISP is hostile. In many parts of the world, ISPs closely monitor internet traffic, sometimes under government directives, like I said before. The goal that they have is typically to collect as much data as possible or to enforce particular web restrictions. By using a Tor bridge, your connection to the Tor network becomes obfuscated, making it challenging for your ISP to discern that you're accessing Tor. And this helps users in censorship-heavy regions connect to an uncensored internet and enhances privacy for those looking to prevent their ISP from snooping on their browsing habits. If you have had issues with an ISP complaining about you using Tor, then you should probably use a bridge. Completely outsource your connection to an open Wi-Fi access point or alternative if possible. If this isn't possible, then bridges are a great alternative to that. This additional layer of anonymity is critical, especially in an era where digital privacy is increasingly under threat by so many different threat actors. Bridges offer a lifeline for those that are under the shadow of state censorship and any user who values keeping their online activities out of their ISP's or government's prying eyes. I don't recommend using a bridge unless your threat model demands it, and if you're unsure then you need to do more research before even trying this out. But WebTunnel is a step forward in the ongoing cat and mouse game with censors. It disguises Tor traffic as regular HTTPS web traffic, which means that to anyone monitoring your internet usage, it looks like you're just visiting regular websites and not using Tor at all. The real genius of WebTunnel is that it can operate alongside normal web traffic on a server, making it even harder for censors to detect and block. So, for example, the comparison between WebTunnel and another bridge type, OBFS4 is one of the more well-known ones. OBFS4 attempts to make Tor traffic look random and unrecognizable. This is great for some use cases, but for those who need camouflage, not an annihilation of Tor traffic, WebTunnel takes a different approach by mimicking regular web traffic, which is more effective in places that only allow known or proved types of internet traffic. In an environment where most unknown traffic types are blocked, WebTunnel's ability to look like regular HTTPS traffic gives a very significant advantage, giving like a ghillie suit to your browsing habits, basically. For those interested in supporting Tor and helping others bypass censorship, setting up a WebTunnel bridge could be a valuable contribution. The Tor Project guides those who want to set up their bridges and donate bandwidth. If you're interested in seeing me do a video on this very topic, then let me know in the comments below and I will add it to the long to-do list that I already have. The next video, which I've already pushed aside now twice, will be about predicting or spotting signs of an exit scam. It's essential to keep WebTunnel updated and to report any issues or feedback directly to the Tor Project. The Tor Project relies on user experiences to improve its tools. WebTunnel's effectiveness can vary by region, and feedback definitely helps the Tor Project adapt and refine the technology. Acknowledging the volunteers and the collective effort behind WebTunnel highlights a more broad fight against internet censorship. Currently, there are over 700 daily users across the globe and 60 bridges of WebTunnel. It's a testament, if you will, to the community's resilience. However, its effectiveness is not uniform across all censored regions. So, pointing to the continuous challenge of ensuring unrestricted internet access to everyone is definitely something that is a real thing. Using a WebTunnel bridge effectively enhances your online privacy and bypasses censorship. So let's look at how to get one and use it. Remember, if you don't need this, then don't use them. There are people in other countries whose threat model is dependent on things like this. So, how do we get a WebTunnel bridge? If we actually need one. WebTunnel bridges are actually super easy to find. They're available exclusively right now through the Tor Project's official bridge distribution site. Further updates aim to expand availability to platforms like Telegram and Moat. So we'll start by opening the usual web browser and navigating to the Tor Project bridge website. Look for advanced options and select WebTunnel from the dropdown, then click on Get Bridges. Complete the captcha and proceed. Copy the provided bridge line for later use. The next step will be setting up Tor browser for your desktop. I prefer to use Tails operating system. That's definitely your first choice, but this is just how to use the bridge. You can apply the same methodology to Tails, but WebTunnel bridges require the latest version of the Tor browser to function, so keep that in mind. Download the most recent Tor browser version for your desktop from the official Tor Project website. The version should be 12.5 point something or later. WebTunnel represents a significant advancement in maintaining internet freedom and privacy. By understanding and supporting technologies like Tor and WebTunnel, we can all contribute to a more open and accessible internet, which benefits everybody. As a side note, my personal favorite overlay network is I2P, hands down. The federal government does not fund it, and it has no centralization and can have multiple hops on nodes, whereas Tor is limited. In addition, I2P is E2EE or end-to-end encrypted. Also, unlike Tor, they don't wrap up every year with millions of dollars in excess donations. Ideally, you should host an I2P relay in Snowflake. Snowflake lets you host a bridge easily by installing a simple browser add-on. And if you let me into your house and you let me use your computer, I will install this browser add-on by default. I do it to anyone's computer I touch. So it's just gonna, that's what's gonna happen. We're all supporting the Tor project. In any case, happy World Day Against Cyber Censorship, everyone. And I will see you in the next video.